Hi, I am making these videos mainly because I didn't found anything like this, and what I want to show you it's how to repair a keyboard with films, not mechanical keyboard, normal keyboard. I encountered this problem as my keyboard, Razer one, stopped working after I spilled something on it. So basically, some keys didn't work. This is an example keyboard. I will show you what you need to do. Let's say this is your keyboard that you want to repair, and you want to continue using it, not throw it and buy another one. First of all, remove all the screw. My keyboard is open, it's only for parts, this keyboard, as I don't have the receiver anymore. Let me adjust a little bit. So you open the keyboard, you pop out the keyboard. Let's see. In most of the keyboards you will find something like this. Oh, gummy plastic, rubber key, rubber keys. You don't need it. What happens in keyboard? That first, to repair it, you need to understand how it works. So every keyboard, if it's not mechanical, has this three layer of plastic with printed circuits on it. The main problem why this stops working is because the circuits, after you spill something or for if you use it for a long time, so the circuits want to try something. I don't, looks like I can't scratch the circuit. Basically the circuit gets burned and doesn't contact anymore. Every points contacts with this logic board, gets the signal. What you need, there are two films with printed circuits. You need to debug them and watch what button doesn't work, and starting from, let's say that this is a T and T doesn't working. Starting from this point, you go around the line until you find the spot that looks like it's broken. On the back you see better. I will scratch it for you to actually okay. I will scratch it now to see how it looks like. I hope that I can. So on the back it will look something like this. You see the broken line? You'll see, it's pretty obvious when it's broken, you'll see a broken line. So, let me scratch a little more. Okay. Now, it's obvious the difference. To tell the difference, there is the broken line of graphite, of printed circuit. The circuit, it's broken. It can't transfer the signal anymore. So what you need to do to actually repair, no, you will not change the foil, because you can't find foils exactly for the keyboard. In best case, if it's expensive, if it's a keyboard that costs $5, I think it's more convenient to buy another one. So what you need to do is, I will rip this off right now. So you take another foil from a spare part keyboard that you don't use, don't need. You remove the foil, you measure the distance that you need to repair, and cut a piece with printed circuit from the part foil. After that, I rip this just for demonstration. After that, where the circuit is broken, verify the foil on which side it is. This side up. If you scratch the graphite on this side, you will see that it's only plastic, and this you will feel that it's with circuit on it. So basically, verify this piece again, and you simply put on top of that, face to face, the graphite's line circuit, and to form another piece of circuit. As you can see, let me broken and continuously circuit. So it should work again. After you put this, you take some tape. Of course, this is a bad piece of circuit what I did here. What you need, or what you want to do, is to cut one circuit point to point and put two points are bigger and better chances to work. So you basically take a piece of transparent tape, cut it. I cut myself huge. I cut the piece huge, put the printed circuit on the missing circuit. Be careful, printed circuit that it's here and here to touch this part. So put this eye here and then stick some tape. I move the circuit a little bit. Okay. Take mine again. I take the circuit again and put it here. Put some tape. For the demonstration, let's say it's okay. Verify that it looks like it continues, then put the file back, this file, and actually try the point, to touch the point and see if it's working. If the key works, you repair the film correctly, and it continues the signal. If not, you will need to try to place the little part with circuit on this one another time. Hope you understand. I know that my English is not super good, and if you have some questions, please leave a comment. I will gladly answer and help you repair your keyboard. I did these videos because I couldn't find another video with repairing things like this. Hope it helps you. Have a nice day. Bye.